Joining me now from Auburn, Maine, political activist and candidate for United States Senate, Linda Wooten. Linda, they're coming after the guns. You know, the Democrats have made no bones about it. We heard it during the debate in South Carolina. Article 1, Section 16 of the Maine Constitution says that the right to bear arms shall never be questioned. Seems to me like these candidates are questioning it.
They're questioning it way too much, even with the red flag laws that Susan Collins is trying to propose, actually, right now, which would allow a family member to call the authorities concerning they're afraid that their family member is going to harm themselves or someone else. Without any proof, the authorities can go to that person's home and confiscate the gun.
Right, no due process. A complete and total obliteration of the half of the Bill of Rights. You're running against Susan Collins. Susan Collins is disliked from coast to coast among many circles in Republican parties. She's disliked because effectively she's a rhino. Collins is representing the great state of Maine right now. She has 8 opponents, 5 Democrat, 3 independents. Of course, Maine went for Hillary in 2016, but Collins right now has a Liberty score of F12%. She has a straight F when it comes to the Second Amendment. But this is something that you hope to turn around if you happen to get into the United States Senate?
Absolutely. You know, I was Republican not too long ago, and I was on the platform committee as well, the Maine GOP platform committee, where we defended individuals' right to keep and bear arms in a court of the U.S. and Maine constitutions, yet they continue to support Susan Collins, who is clearly against gun rights.
Susan Collins also has a straight F when it comes to moral issues. Moral issues, a.k.a., for example, abortion. And there was just a vote this week on a couple of abortion bills on Wednesday. She voted in favor of the Born Alive legislation, but she voted against the Pain Capable. I don't know exactly how you rationalize a split vote like that, except maybe, excuse the pun, try and split the baby. But it's either a life or it isn't, in the womb and outside the womb.
Yeah, she's been consistently banning any rights to life of the unborn. That was one of the first I'd seen where she voted in favor of the Born Alive bill. But then again, within a few weeks, she does this with the voting against the 20-week ban.
How would you have voted on those?
Pardon me?
How would you have voted on those two?
I am totally for life from conception. And I would have voted yes, of course, on the Born Alive bill. I would have voted for the 20-week ban.
Susan Collins also voted in favor of, during the impeachment process, in favor of, quote, hearing from witnesses, which in my opinion is a vote against the Constitution. In the end, she voted to acquit the President of the United States. Is that what voters of Maine want? Do they want a senator who's wishy-washy like that?
No. In fact, as many conservatives who don't dare to vote conservative because she keeps going back and forth. She teases them almost on, okay, I'm going to do this to appease this crowd, but I'm going to do this other opposite thing to appease the other crowd. It's her way to get reelected. I will not do that. I will be quite honest with the people. This is where I stand.
The website for you is Wooten, that's W-O-O-T-E-N, FORME, abbreviation for Maine, WootenForME.com. If people would like to help you early retire or maybe late retire, she's been there since 1996 after all, Susan Collins. Linda, thank you.
Want to see more videos like this? Click on the link below and subscribe to One America News on YouTube and call your cable provider and kindly demand that One America News is added to your lineup. Call and subscribe today.